guidance. I know that tonight does not mark the ultimate fulfillment of our purpose, but it is a milestone. Thank you for your the faculty, staff, and administration that have used their talents and time to invest in us these past 13 years. I'm grateful for our families and those who have supported us and sacrificially given. I also thank you for allowing us, the class of 2022, to spend these years together, building relationships and making memories that will last forever. I ask you to plant within each of us a dream, and that Proverbs 3:5-6 will be true in our lives as we trust in you, Lord, with our hearts and lean not on our own understanding. May we acknowledge you in all our ways and live with the assurance that you direct our paths. Father, we each bring our own set of hopes and challenges here tonight. Thank you for reminding us we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. May you not only be glorified in our graduation, but in the journey that lies ahead for each of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sorry. While high school is not made to last forever, it is one of the many goals we achieve in life. From the day we first started school, we have made friends and lifelong memories that we'll cherish forever. Today, we look back at this unforgettable journey and love we have built together. Of course, it has been filled with many ups and downs, but we each have found a way to push through. Today will be no different. We will be moving on from our teenage years and into adulthood. We will be saying goodbye to a part of our lives and to all the people who have taught us so much. We will be parting ways with our classmates whom we have known for years to start a new journey. However, we look forward to what the future holds for us. New adventures, new friends, and for a new life ahead of us. During these last 4 years, we have come to be thankful of everyone and everything we have. We would like to thank God first, because without Him, none of this would be possible. We thank our families, friends, and teachers for their love and support they have given us. We must also thank and congratulate ourselves for working hard and coming to school, even if it can be a little late. To my classmates, I wish you all the best for the coming years in our lives. May we all keep growing to the best of our abilities. May God in His wisdom bless us with success. I'm proud to be called your classmate and share precious memories with you. This is not a goodbye forever, but until we meet again. Once again, welcome and thank you all for joining us in the graduation ceremony of the class of 2022.
At this time, I would like to recognize our stage guests. Please hold your applause until everyone is introduced. Stage guests, please stand and remain standing until all of you have been recognized. Board of Education Chairman Stanley Thrift. Board of Education Vice Chairperson Charlie May Cross. Board of Education members Gail Enfinger and Eric Harris. Superintendent, Dr. Lori James. Assistant Principal, Susan Fortner. Guidance Counselor, Chastity Luke. Graduation Coach, Dr. Becky Morgan. Senior Class Sponsors, Lee Douglas, Terrence George, Kara Goodman, and Laurie Malcolm. Thank you for the endless time, support, and encouragement you've shown to these seniors throughout their high school career. We also ask that everyone remain seated throughout the graduation ceremony. No one should be leaving until the ceremony is over. It is a sign of respect to honor each graduate for their hard work and accomplishments. So please remain seated so we can show respect towards each graduate. Thank you for your cooperation as the class of 2022 has their shining moment in history.
Eleanor Roosevelt once stated, "Many people will walk in and out of your life, but only true friends will leave footprints in your heart." The class of 2022 is a perfect example of this statement. Hello, I'm Jelena King, Vice President of Class of 2022. 15 years ago, we all met for the first time as we started First Baptist Kindergarten in Head Start. We would soon become friends with our new classmates, but little did we know, these friends would impact our journey ahead so much. For some of us, it took a while to become friends. We can all blame Maddie for that. Her mom was a school teacher, and she already knew everything we needed to know about school, and she let us know often. It was her way or the highway, but she personally had us ready for the big school when it was time. One of my best memories is of my friend, Kirsten. She and I clicked instantly. Kirsten is highly allergic to peanuts. I remember going through her lunchbox and inspecting all of her food before she ate it to make sure she didn't have peanuts. I could barely read, but I knew what the word peanuts looked like. Why I thought her own mother would give her nuts, I never knew.
Maybe we were all a little bossy.
Our time at Clinch County Elementary was cut short, but these were the glory days. Recesses were long. Work was short, responsibilities were minimal, and naps were the best. Gym was our favorite class of the day. We couldn't wait to get to the big rainbow parachute. Sometimes we'd go out to the playground where we would race to get to the swing sets and monkey bars. One memory of the famous playground that we will forever not forget is when Khalil tried to show off how he could hang upside down on the monkey bars. His success was short-lived. However, Khalil fell hard on the concrete and bust his head open. The next day, our group of friends gathered at the monkey bars and had an ongoing service for our dear classmate, who was not dead, but in our minds, he was. If you're thinking this story, getting it better, it's gonna get better. Middle school was filled with fun memories, just as how cool we were becoming. Our field trip to the Georgia Aquarium was awesome, and so we were walking around in the big city. I know everyone remembers our cool groups we had around this time, too. The Blue Jays, Jada Cleary, Jada Thomas, and I sang, danced, and we rapped. We practiced for all of our famous performances, and we were sure we would be the next Cheetah Girls. Ike and Maddie were the power couple of middle school. No one will ever forget poor JR's middle school struggle. We were all experts in those weeks. Middle school was also the time where we started to get active in Clinch County's athletic program. From cheerleading, football, basketball, band, and man did everyone want to be in band. As we all got ready to choose our instruments, we thought best suited us. One special someone found a love for the saxophone. our very own Easton Rodriguez, aka E-Money. Although Easton once choked on his reed and taken a deep breath through his mouth, he survived and became the best drum major of all time. Fast forward to where our glory days came, and we went straight into the Clinch County High School. We gained friends, we lost friends, we had our first kisses and our first heartbreaks. We also learned what stress was and what due at 11:59 was. Our responsibilities became real responsibilities, but we all had to help each other, especially Banks. We all know she still struggles with time management. We also will never forget her special lunch boxes she often had that broke and left her apples rolling around the hall of CCSJ. With Talia, you never know what would come out of her mouth at any given time, but she would surely make us all laugh. From FFA to Beta, from homecomings to proms, from our elite student section to class clowns, CCHS has offered so many memories that will hold a special place in our hearts. I know for Jada it will. She nearly jumped out of her prom dress when they said her prom week. Moments like these will have us reminiscing the good times. Our class is known for three things: being superheroes, thanks to Khalil for picking Miss Lori up in the parking lot; being talented entrepreneurs; and for being the biggest complainers of all time. The 2020 pandemic gave our complaining skills an extra boost. These stories on this graphic surface of the memories that my classmates and I share. Some are funny, some are frustrating, and some are sad. Our senior year coming to a close has made us realize that this time in our lives will forever be special. We have become a family. We are each other's shoulders to cry on, inside and outside of school. We've had each other's back since we can remember, and going forward, because all we have shared, we always will. Look at us now. Accepted into our dream schools, and all dressed in our cap and gowns. About to jump a bridge we've been waiting for since eighth grade. I would personally like to say to my classmates, thank you. Thank you for making our years the best. As we all leave here tonight, remember that you are strong and you can do anything you put your mind to. I wish you all the best luck in your future. Go be great. I love y'all.
Each year, the graduating class purchases a gift for the school with the remaining funds left in their class account. This year, the remaining funds will go to the purchase of new tables and tablecloths. We hope that these tables and tablecloths will be used in upcoming events held in future years. This gift is a symbol of our gratitude to the school for these last 5 years.
Some tears and had hard times as well as countless good times, but now it must come to an end. As close as our class has grown together, we must now go our separate ways and start our new lives, but we will forever remain a family. Each member is taking a different path and heading in different directions, but all with the same goal: to make something of ourselves and give back to the world that has made us who we are. We all have our own aspirations and dreams to follow. As Minor Meyer Juniors once said, go into the world and do well, but most importantly, go into the world and do great. Each of us has had the opportunity to make an impact of goodness in the world, and it is my hope and prayer that each of us will reach that goal. The class of 2022 has faced all possible difficulties. We have made it through COVID-19, where we endured virtual learning, a semester being cut short, and being distanced from our teachers, as well as our peers. Through all the tribulations, we still strive to learn and achieve our goals. Our educational experience has been filled with many challenges. As we go out into the quote-unquote real world, there will be many challenges and obstacles that will try to break us down. But the Lord says, with Him by our side, nothing will be able to overcome us, because with Him, all things are possible. There is nothing in this world that we are not capable of doing. Thank you to the class of 2022 for being the best friends and classmates I could have asked for. And thank you to my family for helping me get where I am. You make it worth it. Thank you to every teacher who supported our class and the cafeteria ladies for keeping us well fed. Thank you to the bus drivers who got us to and from school every day. And all of the staff from Baptist Kindergarten and Head Start and all the way up to high school who played a part in our educational careers. For the past couple of years, I've had a quote as a home screen on my phone that says, "Forget the maps and follow your instincts." I remember scrolling through the Pinterest one day looking for something that would speak to me, and I couldn't have found a more perfect quote. Those who know me know how scary this is for me. I wasn't too sure what I wanted to stand up here and say tonight, but I did know that I wanted to say something meaningful. I didn't have to look too hard for something to talk about because it was right in front of me. I think a lot of us can agree that life doesn't always go as planned, but despite that fact, we just have to push through and make the best of the situation. All of this being said, I wanted to give some advice to the class of 2022 and even maybe some people out there in the audience. Life won't always happen the way you plan it, so don't fret. It's good to set goals and try to achieve them, but life isn't a completely straight path. You're going to be presented with so many opportunities in life, and I challenge you to not be afraid to take those opportunities, even if it wasn't originally in your plans. Especially for those of us that are about to graduate, forget the maps and follow your instincts. A reminder to not be afraid of your instincts and embrace them. Allow yourself to come out of your comfort zone and try something new.
Class of 2022. Well, guys, today is the day. Today is the day we close this chapter of our lives. Finally cross the line, to reach the stars, and sad to say, goodbye to each other in dear old CCHS. It's time to graduate. It's hard to believe that 5 years ago we arrived at Clinch County High School, not as freshmen, but as sub-freshmen. It's also hard to believe how fat I was when we were in eighth grade. Over the past 13 years, we loved each other like that. We cared for each other like that. And we became family. We've made memories that will last a lifetime. Not only have we had the time of our lives, but we've learned so much along the way. We began high school as children, but we are leaving as adults. Others will go straight into the workforce. Some of us will go into college. But each of us will travel our own path. Yet we would be crossing this stage on our way to bigger and better things without the help of a few people. To our wonderful teachers, thank you so much for sharing your time, talent, and knowledge with us. Thank you for setting the bar high and challenging us to live up to it, even though sometimes we thought that bar was too high. You encouraged us, you inspired us, you poured into us. You became part of our family. To our sponsors, thank you for those moments in homeroom where you gave us advice that we may not have asked for, but we needed. Thank you for helping us build the most amazing, non-winning floats ever built in homecoming history for the last 5 years. Volcano should have won. You are definitely part of our family. I love you all. To the administration, thank you for keeping things running smoothly. Thank you for teaching us the importance of discipline and kindness. We also thank you for going easy on us for the small things, like when I sprayed Doug in the face with scissors we made, right? To the lunch staff, thank you so much for feeding us every day and always doing it with a smile. Miss Renee and the rest of the lunchroom ladies, I don't know if you're here or not, but I just want to say, for the whole class that we all love you so much. To our parents and guardians and friends, thank you for supporting us in every way possible. Allow me to be the one to thank you for everything you have done for us. The late night drives back from ball games, to waking up early to make sure we got to school on time. Thank you for acting like a parent to us, even if we weren't your child. Many of the faces in this crowd took care of me as if I were one of their own. And for that, I thank you. Fellow graduates, I hope you always cherish the memories you made as a Clinch County High School and never take them for granted. With every homecoming week, every ball game, we became family. With every class, every lunch break, and ball practice, we became family. Every morning, we frantically rushed to get the homework we forgot to do the night before, we became family. But sadly, all good things must come to an end. While yes, most of my humor in this speech was to keep you from crying, this is not a goodbye. It's just to see you later. Some of us may be leaving, but in our hearts, we will always be a Clinch County family. Class of 2022, we all became family over our time in high school. I love every single one of you, even though a lot of you find me annoying as crap. But you will always be a part of my family. Now guys, I'm sure you all remember the first day of our first pep rally in eighth grade. I stood right there and I yelled, "Let's go ahead and pray," at the top of my lungs. So it only seems right that I leave the way I came in. Let's go class of 2022!
The members of the graduating class of 2022 have had the requirements and criteria that were set forth by the State Board of Education and the Clinch County Board of Education. I present to you the students that received diplomas as the class of 2022. Honor graduates, would you please stand? Camilla Pineda. Maddie Logan McQuaid. Karen Aramis Thompson. John Rustin Goodman. Jelena Matrice King. Chelsea Verona Corbett. Courtney Nicole Mathis. Aniston Rebecca Hendricks. Banks Ashton Gaines.
Alexandria Denise Hitman. Wyatt Samuel Beverly. Amazing Georgia Burns. David Zachary Payson. Avion Denise Clark. Jada D'Avion Cleary. Benjamin James Crosby. Lolita Quavis. Michael Blainley Day. Emma Kirsten Dell. Alberry Durham. McKenna Montgomery Edmond. Caleb Lee Fender. Asia Nicole Fluger. Nicholas Kane Greenley. Gracie Annalise Herring. Tyler Reed Howell. Janadia Rashay Jackson. Khalil Tyrese Jenkins. Thank you. Ikea Johnson. Michael Lynn King. Bailey Marie Lawson. Kavarion Richard Lee. Jamarcus Tyrone Marshall. Johnny Leroy Marshall III. Javon McCray. Juan Jose Medina Jr. Jaquito LaBruce Merriweather. Dana Sharon Roy. Haley Anna Mosley. Michaela Naomi Murray. Varun Jagar Tail. Jamari Khalil Priester. Braden McRae Register. Davion Zamar Risha. Easton Jude Rodriguez. Braxton Deshaun Smith. Ike Davis Smith. Smith.
Would the class of 2022 and guests please bow your heads as we close in prayer. Lord, bless and guide each graduate as we reach the end of this chapter in our lives. Lord, allow us to learn from the past to better ourselves for the future. I pray that all graduates put you first above all in their lives and accomplish their goals. Lord, keep a hedge of protection around the class of 2022 as we take our first steps into the real world. Amen.
Please stand.
the class of 2022, you may now move your tassels. I'm not sure if we're ready for this, but you are now officially kicked out of the CCHS nest. Shine bright and make us all proud. Congratulations to each of you, and may God bless you all. Family and friends, immediately following the alma mater, graduates traditionally toss their caps in the air. Afterwards, they will hear their class song one last time as they exit the gym. Once every senior has fully exited the gym, you may join us on the field for music and fireworks. Will everyone please stand for the alma mater led by the class officers?